bear with me. I'm sorry if you're tired of me talking about BTS and BLACKPINK so much lately, but you gotta understand that with BLACKPINK's comeback last week and BTS's comeback this week, so much happens surrounding them, and a lot of my requests are to talk about those things anyways. Don't worry, I'll have some other things to talk about for the next one. And before we get to all the controversy that has happened in the past 24 hours, can I just say, I am super excited for Boy With Love. You know, when I hear this Western artist or that singer wants to collab with BTS, I honestly don't really care for it. Not that I don't want it, because sometimes it's amazing. I just don't always need it. Am I alone on this? How do you guys feel about it? But, BTS with Halsey? I'm all in. I'm all in. I actually really like her songs, performances, her style, and when she actually appeared in the teaser with BTS, I knew she was all in for this collab as well, so that makes me excited. Nicki Minaj. I'm just kidding, I like Nicki Minaj. By the way, the theory and explanation I have for the Persona trailer, after seeing this new teaser, I've decided to combine it with the full explanation video that's coming out on Friday. Just trust me. Okay, speaking of BTS's comeback, let's get into it. You guys have probably heard or even saw, but it looks like things were leaked. I'm curious, how many of you guys saw or heard anything from these leaks? I first saw the outrage against a girl who works at Target or Walmart that leaked a shipment box containing the Map of the Soul Persona albums. I came across the pictures and people who saw her post said that she said it was fine because we already know what the album looks like. I don't think it's fine because it's this kind of no self-control that leads to the next thing that happened. And that was someone else got a hold of one of the albums and leaked a song. Luckily, Big Hit seems to have taken those down, maybe, hopefully. But if you guys don't want to hear it, just be careful on social media. Personally, I would say try to stay away from it just out of respect. It's kind of crazy because while all of this was going on, people were reporting that in some places, some Targets, the albums were on the shelves already. Not just empty spaces preparing for Friday's release, but some were even for sale. I saw one account where someone saw an unwrapped album. I believe Target has already addressed some of these, but it's weird how this happened at multiple different locations. I kind of want to go check a Target near me to see if there's the same issue. If you guys go to Target or something, let me know if you see the same thing. And you know what? Target wasn't the only company that had to come out and address K-pop fans this weekend. Kind of embarrassing for the rest of us, huh? Apparently, someone spread a photo of a fake Starbucks promotion involving BLACKPINK and Kill This Love, and it got to the point where they had to say, guys, this is fake. Actually, you know what? That one's kind of funny. I wonder how many people actually tried to redeem it. Did any of you guys participate? Anyway, while Starbucks was dealing with that, Spotify had to address a troll who faked a screenshot and spread lies about YG setting up unskippable ads which force people to listen to Kill This Love and boost up their views, which is not the way it works, by the way. Spotify addressed it, and then this person even came out and admitted everything they did wrong. This person is crazy. Why would you do this? Why would you create this false narrative to have people attack BLACKPINK? See, so embarrassing to the K-pop community. It just makes all of us look childish and petty. But hey, let's look on the bright side. Let's take a moment to appreciate Lisa's magnificent pants. I mean, her outfit as a whole, but especially these pants. For some reason, they just call to me. I don't know why.